This is Uganda. We're here because MSU is looking at soil. And soil is critical because without healthy soil, you can't grow food.
So we are in the village of Chayantambura today. And primarily what I'm interested in is trying to understand why people are growing more maize today and what growing more maize is doing to their soils.
Here in Uganda, they figure that all of the land that can be farmed will be in the process of being farmed by 2020. So when all that land is in action, growing different things, they have to make sure that the soil is healthy, that they're rotating the crops, so that the right nutrients are in the land. Well, that's why Lisa Tiemann is here from Michigan State, to make sure it stays healthy so that people can feed their families and so that people can live.
We've gotten permissions from the local chairman of this village, and now we're just kind of going out and randomly finding houses that somebody is home or somebody that's working in a field, and we'll ask them if they're okay with doing an interview with us and sampling soil from their fields.
What do you think you're going to find? What are you going to be looking for?
We're going to measure the extent of the field. We're going to create a GPS track around the edges of the field. Then we're going to take soil samples from three random locations within the field that we'll take back to Michigan State for analysis. So I've been back and visited many of the villages that I've sampled from. So based on data that I've collected here, we have 40 to 50% losses of soil organic matter. And soil organic matter is really the keystone of soil fertility.
Maize or corn is easy to grow and easy to sell for a good price here. But it wipes out the soil and makes it less and less productive. And now that all this land is on the verge of being used, which means these farmers who used to move around a lot can't move much anymore, Lisa is here to help them learn how to turn around the declines and hopefully have lots of healthy soil.
This is their maize here. You can see how much taller and better it looks than this maize over here. And this, I suspect, is because they're using the manure.
Is she glad to have this kind of information? I mean, to what's in the soil and what she's going to be able to grow?
That she thinks if the results are brought back and she thought maybe on how to improve her farming systems, she thinks maybe she's going to benefit in the future.
How many years was this in maize before she did this work?
She takes what she finds to the local farmers and is also working with partners in Uganda with the ultimate goal of improving food security. That means making sure there's enough food for everyone across the country.
Right now they're balancing a very fine line. It's, you know, we have to grow enough crops so that we can sell for profit, that we have enough money for school fees. We have to have enough crops so that we can feed our family, and we have to have enough crops so that we have seed for the next season. So it's a very fine balance and a very fine line to make sure that you have all of those things. And as soil fertility declines, something is going to have to give.